Prime Minister of Israel.
Yes, hello there. Well, just fine. It's good to see you again.
Good seeing you. I'm delighted. Okay. You look well.
I feel good, except that the state of the average. It's a long time of the year for us.
Well, but the sun is kind to you anyway.
Yes, yes. Well, let us come in here and sit down. I think we'll just have to smile and small talk for
you. Fine.
You remember the experience of the United Waves of photographers. Terrible. Waves of photographers coming in. First one, I think, will be our risk our own review.
Thank you very much.
Well, it's good to see you.
This is a very moving occasion. This is really good. How?
Well, she's had some wonderful experiences. She's visited many of these centers for young people, children. What most people don't realize yet is children down to the age of 10 that are being exposed to drugs. And she's heard the stories of some of these children and their parents then. And all this is meant. And it's getting fantastic.
And the girl that I can tell you
President, do we support a conference that would allow the Russians to have something to say about the Middle East?
Sam, I'm not going to take any questions on this. We haven't even had a chance to talk or discuss yet, so.
Well, as I understand, the Prime Minister and President Mubarak thought a conference was a good idea.
I think President Mubarak and Hussein and myself, all of us, are for direct negotiations. No international conference can substitute direct negotiation. It may support it, provided that all the parties will support peace and support the participants in the negotiation process.
Including the Russians, would they help?
Theoretically, yes. But then all of us have to wait quite a period of time before the Russians will re-establish themselves as a qualified party for this conference. They have to re-establish diplomatic relations with all parties. They have to change their attitude toward the Russian jewelry. And I don't anticipate that this is going to happen in the near future.
How about the Palestinians? Who have a direct state?
Nobody suggests today a direct state for the Palestinians. I think the best way to solve the Palestinian problem is within a Jordanian-Palestinian framework.
Do you like the president's September 1st, 1982 initiative?
As a party man, yes. My party accepted it as an initiative. The National Union government did not take a stand on it.
Mr. Shamir doesn't like it, and he's the next prime minister, is he not?
He is the next prime minister, but the government is not built only on offices, it is built on policies.
Are you thinking from the target?
I can tell you this photo op. It took about 3.5 minutes ago.
I really want to say on for my own initiative. We're extremely grateful to the United States and to the President of the United States that time and again has helped us to overcome many of the difficulties on the road to peace, including the latest one, Mr. President, with Egypt, which was a touch-and-go situation. And wouldn't it be for the American very determined and measured interference, maybe it would have.
Okay, thank you.
You couldn't have negotiated.
I have to go now. Thanks. I'd like to stay.
He's a very eloquent man.
I know. Go.
So make them asking me questions.
Mr. Giron apologized to you, did he not?
Yes. Yes.
We have two waves in, or is that one first?
I think we've got one more.
One more? That would be enough. Yes.
Sie schicken sich einen Grund für ein Everyday-Film.
Maintaining a sense of order and brings some more
peace. You're a child of the youth.
Oh, yes. You're down on this side, and I'm going to meet your people here.
You're the ambassador.
Yes, sorry, Ben. How are you?
Thank you
so much.
So nice seeing you again.
General Premier, Director of the Prime Minister's Office, Mr. Uri Sabir, who is advisor to the Prime Minister.
Hello.
General
Nebo.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
We lost him.
Thank you very much.
Mr. Prime Minister, 2 years as Prime Minister have been, I must say, have been treated remarkable accomplishments. Stabilization of your economy and the withdrawal from Lebanon, the symmetry that you've had with Arab leaders, and I'm especially gratified by the state of our relations, as all of us are here, and much of that is the result of your leadership and vision. And we want to maintain a continuity in the relationship, sustain the initiatives that have already have been taken. Congratulate you also on Tama, your summit, and hope that this will give new impetus to Israeli and Egyptian relations, and we'll do all that we can to help. And I know you must have some things on the agenda of your own, and so I defer to you.
Mr. President, it's very years under your leadership and your administration. A most unusual relationship was developed between our country and yours, and we have benefited a great deal out of it. And so did peace and happiness, as you have mentioned today. We are in an entirely different situation.
Peoples. And so again, I say it's been a pleasure having Prime Minister Peres here.
Of yet another most productive meeting where your dedication to peace in the Middle East. We laid out policies and strategies for peace, security, and economic development. These were mostly accomplished, much due progress, all paved the ground for the next phase. There is always a difference between uprooting a tree, which requires constant patience, cultivation. I am certain that together we can sail to new strain in appearance and dedication in content. The next step should be directed to a can support such negotiations, not substitute it, ground between each of the parties concerned. An international support can provide the parties with an opportunity of an opening occasion. For the international participation, we shall accept only parties that respect peace and human rights, and we shall not compromise.